Hi everyone, I have some exciting news. The new 1/4 inch Optolong L Ultimate filter is finally here. Optolong sent me an early sample of this filter to test it out before making it available for sale. The L Ultimate is a narrowband deep sky filter that is designed to block light pollution, maximize the signal from nebula, and darkness the sky background. The 3 nanometers dual band filter isolates the nebula's emission into H-alpha, red, and oxygen 3, green, blue. This means it will allow a very narrow bandpass of light while rejecting all other wavelengths, including most of the light pollution from city lights or the full moon. Here is an example of two exposures with Messier 27. In one image, we cannot see clear the nebula because of the strong light gradients coming from the moon. And after, I used the Optolong L Ultimate filter. The difference was amazing. Suddenly, I could see Messier 27 in my image without the light pollution gradients. Let's see another example with a 240 seconds image of Messier 16, the Eagle Nebula, taken with an UHC filter with medium light pollution. And here is another 240 seconds image with Messier 16 taken with the full moon in the sky. Even if I had more light pollution gradients when using the L Ultimate, the gradients and the light pollution is not visible in the image and reveals the Eagle Nebula with good contrast. Now let's see the first test with the Optolong L Ultimate on the emission nebula NGC 2359, also known as the Thor's Helmet Nebula, an emission nebula in the constellation Canis Major. To capture this nebula, I decided to use my 5-inch Maxutov telescope that has a focal length of 1500 mm and a f ratio of f12. Having a higher focal length will enable me to capture more details, but because of the slow focal ratio, it needs more integration time to obtain a good signal-to-noise ratio in the image. And this makes it a challenge imaging the Thor's Helmet Nebula because it is also dimmer at apparent magnitude of 1145 and also at a lower altitude in the sky. I use my larger sensor astronomy camera, the Altair 26C, to test also if the 1/4 inch L Ultimate filter is usable with APS-C size sensor cameras like the Altair 26C or ZW2600MC Pro that has the same sensor size. Doing so, we will be able to observe how much vignette we will have in the images and if we will be able to remove it in post-processing. On smaller sensor size than APS-C, no vignette will be visible. To mount the filter using the Altair 26C camera, I needed an adapter. So I used my ZW magnetic filter drawer with an 1.25-inch metallic filter adapter. Now let's go to the mini PC and start imaging the Thor's Helmet Nebula. Sequencer, detail on at 5 images, okay. I started the plan. I'm trying first 4 minutes exposure time. Here in Stellarium, we can see also the altitude of the nebula, 28 degrees. I might be able to image for 2 hours if the sky will remain clear. So we have 28 degrees altitude in the sky. Moon is up at about 60% illumination. And here we have a framing assistant. Here we have the Thor's Nebula. So you see, I need it to be very exact, very precise at this focal length. I started the plan. We do have now our first image. However, the seeing seems not to be great on the lower part of the sky under 30 degrees. But let's see what we'll be able to get using this setup and Optolong L Ultimate on the Thor's Helmet. After processing the Thor's Helmet Nebula, I was impressed with the result. With only 2 hours integration time, we can see details in the central bubble of expelled material with giant molecular clouds in the area. We can see also details in the arcs extending away from the nebula's central region. I want to show you a comparison with Thor's Helmet using an UHCS nebula filter and the image taken with the Optolong L Ultimate. we can see clear that we have much more contrast in the L ultimate image, and the H alpha and O3 nebulosity is much easier to observe. Using a slow telescope like the Skymax 1.25 has also disadvantages when using a strong narrowband filter like the L ultimate. Because even if this filter will give excellent contrast to emission nebulas and left the same amount of light corresponding to H alpha and O3 wavelengths, it will block the remaining light, hitting the filter, including starlight. And this will make stars appear dimmer and also the background much darker, having also less signal. This means that in short exposures, the signal to noise ratio will not be as good with short exposures compared with other filters. This will result in more background noise. It seems 240 seconds with a 5-inch Maxutov telescope at f12 and 2 hours integration was not enough to obtain an excellent signal to noise ratio. I had to be careful how much I stretched the image so the colors and tones of the nebula, and especially the background, will not become overprocessed and too harsh. In order to overcome these issues, I recommend to take longer exposures and integration time when using the L ultimate filter, especially when you have a smaller nebula in the image and more sky in the background. When stacking images of Thor's helmet nebula, encounter problems because were not enough stars in the image visible to stack. And it was a pain to figure it out at first in Deep Sky Stacker, but I found a solution. To avoid this problem, you need to take longer exposures with a slow telescope, as I mentioned before, or increase the gain of the camera. Since I already captured the images, I had only one option to fix the issue and have enough stars detected in the images: by increasing the brightness in Deep Sky Stacker. RAW fits options. And I changed the brightness value of the image from 1 to 12. Lower values did not allow to stack all the images. Only after doing this, I was able to stack all the data. The L ultimate filter is not optimized for very fast telescopes like RASA or fast lenses like F2. To get 100% signal, I think you need to image from a focal ratio of F4 and above. I have tested the filter with a 360mm focal length refractor telescope, focal ratio F5, and with the Skymax 1.25 1500mm at F12. As you already seen in the final image, on APS-C sensor cameras, the filter does make a small vignette in the corners, but it can be removed using flat calibration frames and linear gradients in post-processing, as I did here using Adobe Camera Raw. However, using a full frame camera sensor, you should opt for the 2-inch version instead. Regarding the stars captured with the L ultimate, we have also an advantage compared with other filters. By having smaller size stars that are not taking contrast from the nebula we are imaging, and we can see better the nebulosity in more details. Here is an example of images taken without filters or with light pollution filters. We can see so many bright stars that makes more difficult to see a lot of details within these nebulas. Well, we do not have this problem with the L ultimate. This filter will provide the best contrast for emission nebulas without having too many distracting stars in our images. Testing on very bright stars, I did notice that the L ultimate 1/4 inch, it will make halos same as the L enhance and L extreme, but only on the brightest stars in the sky. And I will make available this test in a new follow-up video. Now let's see a fast comparison between the L enhance and L ultimate on the Rosette Nebula. Here we have two exposures of 10 minutes taken with both filters. We can see how much better the contrast is in the image taken with the L ultimate. I might make also a future video comparison between L ultimate and other filters like L enhance and L extreme, where you'll be able to see in more details the difference. But looking at just one image, we can see that the L ultimate will provide us with the best contrast possible on emission nebulas, and it's the logical option to get the best astrophotography results from light pollution areas or with the full moon in the sky, also at a good price point. If you want to see also how good the L Ultimate performed under the full moon, don't forget to watch my review of the L Ultimate with the full moon in the sky. I hope you find the video useful, and if you have any questions, please leave them below in the comments. If you enjoyed watching, don't forget to like the video, and I'll see you in the next one.